Hello, everyone. How are you doing today? Before I start, I have a very critical question. How many of you have ordered your test kits online from the Postal Service? Come on, raise your hands. How many of you loved the experience? If you didn't love it, you can leave right now. Okay, so I'm here. Well, thank you, Max, and thank you to the AWS team for inviting me here to speak about our story. And this is the story of how the United States Postal Service geared up to meet a very pressing challenge, right? An initiative that was unprecedented in scale, size, scope, technology, you name it. So around Christmas last year, our Postmaster General, Louis DeJoy, he received a phone call from the White House asking him if we could deliver 500 million test kits by mid-January, right? That was 3 weeks away, right? 21 days. So we're very proud of what happened next in the Postal Service. We're all gloating and gleaming, and rightfully so. And so let's let this video unroll to show you what transpired.
The mission. Deliver 500 million COVID test kits to households across the nation. The timeline? 3 weeks. What happened next was amazing. Postmaster General Louis DeJoy.
Can you work it locally?
We'd have to look at the magnitude of this.
Quickly established a leadership task force and gave clear direction and goals. A quick, simple, and user-friendly online experience was created to handle 20 million orders per hour. A dynamic inventory turnover operation was created. Receiving 500 million test kits from the Department of Health and Human Services to six USPS surface transfer centers. Pallets of cartons containing kits were sent to 49 regional fulfillment centers. At peak, 18.3 million test kits were received a day, and we dispatched these to the fulfillment centers in 4 hours. At the 49 fulfillment centers, kitting operations were established, and employees were trained to execute a standardized end-to-end kitting and labeling operation. Finally, the USPS network expedited next-day and two-day delivery of over 360 million test kits, fulfilling more than 90 million orders through two phases of the operation. Taking on the challenge, the Postal Service leadership and employees rose to the occasion, and we're still delivering.
Thank you. So, thank you. So as you can see in that video, Mr. DeJoy does not shy away from a mission, especially a mission this critical. And as you saw in the video, he immediately convened his leadership team. And as I go through my story, I'm going to kind of tell you some of the lessons that I took away from this initiative. The first one being the age-old leadership lesson, right? Engage your SMEs or your leadership early and often. And Louis did that really well, right? So then, as the video showed you, we set up six surface transfer centers. And to these centers, we were receiving the pallets, millions and millions of pallets of COVID test kits. These pallets were then turned around, and they were sent to one of our 49 fulfillment centers across the country, where they were kitted. So four test kits to an envelope, bubble wrapped, label applied, shipped, released to the mail stream for delivery in 1 to 2 days, right? And here's my leadership lesson number two, go to Gemba. This is a Lean Six Sigma principle, which reminds us to design our processes alongside the people that are doing the work. So we did pilot this process. We tested it with our folks on the ground. And that's why we were able to train over 2,000 employees in a week. Okay, so now I'm going to kind of step aside and talk to you about the technology side of this. I'm the CIO, and my team we developed all the systems that were impacted, right? So whether it was the ordering system, the fulfillment system, the customer care system, the visibility, the tracking systems, you name it. So of course, this was a very exciting initiative. We've never done anything like this before, but it was very daunting. And that's a true nightmare that I did have, right? CIO delays COVID test kit distribution because website is down, right? That's all we talked about in the CIO team was how do we keep this website up, right? So what did we do? We had to stand up a website. We didn't know how many orders an hour. We didn't know how many orders concurrently. We were asked to plan for about 1 million an hour. And we sat down with our team and said, COVID test kits are in high demand, right? They're not readily available. Is 1 million an hour enough? No. So we went to 5 to 10, and we established a goal of 20 million test kits an hour. So that was the challenge we worked against. Now, I'm in a room full of cloud people, and you know that achieving that goal is no small task, right? So we went to task on it. So what we did was we first looked at our own postal store, which is our storefront for which you can order stamps and shipping supplies, and we geared it up. We just kept throwing servers at it, hundreds of servers. I'm not kidding you, 400, 900 servers at this test site. And then we started testing really early in the game, like on day seven, we were testing, right? Now, that's one of the things we did really well. So here's my lesson number 3, and this is one of our little new coin DevSecOps principles: shift left to test right. So we were testing critical components even before the website was ready, banging at it, millions, you know, using JMeter and saying, let's try this out. And we came to 1 million an hour on our on-prem site and said, too risky. So what did we do next? We then designed an application on cloud, and we decided to go to 2 cloud platforms. Yeah, I know Amazon has 26 regions, so why 2? We were just very nervous. So Amazon was one of the solutions, and then we picked another provider. And so, of course, redundancy rocks, guys, and finally we were able to sleep in my CIO group, right? So what were we going to do, right? So we had to, I just want to give you a word about how our orders came in. So you go into the website, you enter your name and your address. We check your address to make sure it's valid. We check your name to make sure that you haven't ordered more than you're allowed to. And then we send your order off to our inventory management system, and we send you a confirmation email saying your order is good to go. So now I'm going to sort of shift gears and explain to you how we actually designed the system, right? So we developed a 2-click ordering website, and we used static pages to take advantage of AWS CloudFront service to cache the site across the AWS Edge network, right? So we tried to keep it really simple, right? We integrated the order API through the AWS API gateway. And for performance reasons, we limited our real-time synchronous process to only 2 things. Velocity check, make sure that this dude hasn't ordered before, and validate the address, make sure this is a valid address. And so that's what kept it really simple. Everything else was done asynchronously. We used Kafka to decouple the remainder of the work from the real-time API. This included persisting the order for reporting purposes, forwarding the order downstream to our fulfillment applications, and generating the confirmation emails. And for that, we used the AWS Simple Email Service. And all of these components were scaled out in containers running in OpenShift on EC2. And given that this was a very important mission, security was also very critical. So we used multiple of the AWS native services to protect the site and the APIs. Web application firewall was the one we spent the most time on, tweaking all our all our security rule sets. So what did this do for us? At peak, we accepted 10 million orders an hour, 54 million in the first 2 days. Come on, give me a hand. Come on, guys. We have delivered over 380 million test kits, and although the video says 90, I believe we're now at 100 million orders. How's that for a success story? Yeah? So I want to end by telling you that this huge, ubiquitous infrastructure that the Postal Service has is one that we are now using for two services that I'm not sure a lot of people know about. One's called USPS Connect, and there's a deferred delivery segment of it, right? With USPS Connect, shippers can enter their packages at a local post office or at regional facilities to reach customers within their community, regionally or national, with same-day and next-day services. With the deferred delivery option, you can stage your inventory of prepared SKUs in our facilities, and we can label and ship for you, just as we did with COVID. So, which takes me to the last lesson. You can count on us, the US Postal Service, can leverage our infrastructure, just like we did for COVID, in 3 weeks, to provide same-day and next-day service for any business, any organization across the nation. Thank you all. I do want to remind you that the third round of COVID test kit ordering is on. And with this third round, you now get 8 test kits, right? So if you're worried in being in large crowds, go ahead and order it. You can do it online. Thank you.